This is TWiT.
All right, let's move on to our first story. And joining us to talk a little bit about that is Michael Kahn, the Beijing correspondent, IDG News Service at PCWorld.com. Hello, Michael.
Hi.
So the story that we have is that Xiaomi, who's a device maker in China, a very popular one, is moving data outside of China following some privacy concerns. Now, Xiaomi has devices sold in 7 countries in Asia, used to be China only, so they've certainly expanded. They're on tap to sell around 60 million devices this year. So why are they moving servers outside of China?
Well, they've actually been doing this since the start of the year, according to what their vice president said, Hugo Barra, who used to be at Google and who was sort of poached by Xiaomi. But they've been doing this mainly as a way to just reduce the latency in a lot of their e-commerce sites and the software and their phones, which makes a lot of sense if you if your customers are in another country and you want to have those data centers a lot closer. So that makes sense. But they also said that they want to just kind of adhere more to some of the privacy policies in different countries, and they said that this would help do that. And so there is kind of those two different things is what Hugo Barra said in his post the other day.
Earlier this summer, I know Xiaomi was found to be sharing user information with a server in China. F-Secure, a security company, found device numbers, customer phone numbers, phone contacts, text messages, all being shared with no way for customers to opt out. Xiaomi has since allowed opt-out capabilities. But yeah, you mentioned privacy. How much does this have to do with moving at least some software operations outside of China?
Yeah, I mean the privacy thing is obviously a big deal, because especially now with in the recent years with the NSA spying and China itself, there's a lot of concern about that this nation has a lot of censorship, and it also is gets a lot of criticism for allegedly hacking a lot of other countries. And so I think there is, for a Chinese company, it is a little more sensitive for them to deal with these privacy concerns when they have this reputation. The country itself has this reputation it has to deal with. And a lot of those privacy concerns originally were coming out of Taiwan and Hong Kong, which, they're more of a democratic, places, and they're more concerned about what influence China might have, and so that played played a part into generating some of those privacy concerns.
So, Michael Kahn, how difficult operationally will this migration actually be? Because we're reading that obviously, or you wrote that Chinese user data will actually stay on Chinese servers, and then the outside countries of other Asian countries will be migrated. So, is this going to be a thorny process?
Yeah, I imagine it could be a thorny process trying to figure out where your users are, and I'm not even sure if maybe Xiaomi would have to implement something in their phones asking their users, like, where are you really based? And I'm using a Xiaomi phone, and I'm not a Chinese citizen. I'm a U.S. citizen. So could I put my data somewhere else in the U.S. in their data centers with Amazon? Or am I still going to be in the Chinese servers? And so that's a really great question, and it's unclear how that will work. There was no mention in it, but that could be a difficult process.
The MIUI, actually, I keep wanting to say MIUI, MIUI services, sounds like will be housed in Amazon data centers in Oregon, obviously in the U.S., and Singapore. Obviously, MIUI is a stock and aftermarket firmware for smartphones and tablet computers that's based on Android that Xiaomi uses. Michael, being in Beijing and kind of, you know, on the mainland of China and knowing a little bit more about how these brands are seen locally, you know, what is the general sense of Xiaomi as a brand as compared to some other Chinese brands? It sounds like starting in China was very lucrative for the company. They've since expanded, probably would love to get into different markets. Does this make sense, addressing privacy concerns, making sure that the software side of the services is spread out more globally? Is this the right move for a company like Xiaomi in order to compete with other Chinese manufacturers?
Yeah, I think it's definitely the right move, and the earlier the better, because Xiaomi came about just 3 years ago, and at the time they were one reason why they're so successful is that they're offering these phones that are pretty cheap, and but they have a lot of high specs, so you could buy, you know, one phone for like less than half of the price of what an iPhone goes in China. And so that was a big reason why they were so successful and able to really disrupt the market in China by selling these phones at such cheap prices. And obviously that model, they're going to take that model out into the world and try to become a successful international brand. And so I think these privacy concerns are really kind of more of an international coming from the international side, because in China there really isn't as much talk about that. But as Xiaomi, you know, expands, there is going to be concerns from users who, you know, are more sensitive to those privacy issues. And so I think, you know, Xiaomi, I don't think it really thinks of itself as a Chinese company anymore. It has, you know, big visions, and, you know, and to be an international company, you have to adopt international practices. And so to do this as early as possible is the right move.